Students, today we are going to learn EVS 2, chapter number 5, Family Values. What do you understand by family values? Family values means the value that the family is giving us when we are growing up. For example, role in decision making. We learn about honest and dishonest behavior. We learn the honesty in public life, the advantages of cooperation, tolerance and gender equality. Come on, let us study them in detail. In the beginning of the chapter, they have put a question to us. How do we make the decision to go on a trip? For example, we discuss with each other. We offer suggestion while going to in a trip, which place we have to go. Which guest we have to call for our holidays. Maybe you're going to call your friends, etc. How do you help during the preparation of a festival or functions at home? That is when you have any functions or festivals, then you're calling some people at home and what food items are you going to prepare? Come on, now let us learn. Role in decision making. In decision making. We live together in a family. Every person's like and dislikes are different. Thoughts and opinion can also differ. We have different ideas regarding different things. So we discuss about it. We ourselves are different from others. Even so, our thoughts and opinion can match those of others on various topics. We have love and affection for each other. We take care of each other and are concerned about other people's well-being. We talk to each other before making decisions about anything in our house. We consult each other and make decisions that everyone agrees with. For example, we go to a place, we ask each other. We take their opinion. That is the family. In this way, we are part of the decision making in a family. What happens when everyone has a role in decision making? Each person gets the opportunity or chance to say what they think. By asking everyone's opinion, the subject is thoroughly discussed from every aspect, from every side. We feel like a more important part of a family when we see that our opinion is valued. If our ideas and thoughts are being taken by our family, then we feel very happy. Just as we have a role in making decisions in a family, we also have a role of public decision making. For example, when we are 18 years old, we go in for voting. In the newspapers, we read about matters requiring public participation. We feel the need for minor changes in our environment. For example, they have given us one of these examples. Like for example, we grow trees, sometimes we water the plants in the summer season. It is to our advantage that everyone has a role in making decisions about changes in our surroundings. The government we elect make decision regarding public matters. Public matter means street light, roads, and then the public taps which we have. We feel that a decision made by the government is wrong. We register our opinion. In this way, we can be a part of decision making process. Students, we have learned role in decision making and what happens when everyone has a role in decision making. Now we learn something extra which is there in the textbook, that is read and discuss. Here they have told us about the 18 years old people, citizens of India, who are taking part after they are being elected. Citizens participate in municipal budget planning, that is we are getting money, the state government is getting money from the central government and we are spending money for road construction and street lights, etc. citizen crowd to suggest improvement to city development plan, that is above 18 years old, they can go and tell the party leader or the person in charge of what improvements are required in the area. Inauguration of road joining 6 villages, joint efforts by 6 villagers bear fruit. That is, they are informing the public what they have done. Think, be a part of decision making. This decision making process starts from our home. Do not form your opinion merely on the basis of others what we say. We have to share our thoughts, what we feel, and then that will be the decision making will be best for everybody in the house. So that should be done from the home, so that we will learn, and then when we have a chance in stating our opinion publicly, we can do it. In this slide, they are explaining us about honest, dishonest behavior and honesty in public life. Here, can you tell they have asked us 3 questions. In the first question, are free in honest, Shama is dishonest and Mary is honest. The effect of honest and dishonest behavior. We do many different things every day. Sometimes we make mistakes. We are wrong. Mistakes means when we realize that we have made a mistake or when we are wrong, we should talk about it openly with other friends and family. By doing this, we learn to be honest and find a way to correct our mistakes. It is also necessary to be honest and sincere in our work. Why we should be honest and sincerely? Because this will keep our relationship and we will never cheat with each other. If we are honest, we do not have to be afraid. But if we are dishonest, we will lose our self-confidence. We will not be confident. So we must be honest at home as well as in public. Everyone respects an honest person. Honesty is our strength. Now they are going to the next topic, honesty in public life. If we are honest in our public life, we will get better public service and facility. For example, they are telling if we take a ticket and we have to stand in a line and we get late and we run to catch a train or a bus. Okay, so this is not honesty and we are cheating the public for the money. So if each person buys a ticket, honesty, this problem will not arise. Honesty can increase efficiency in public life. We will be very fast. Okay, and the different things, for example, public roads or transport or whatever will be more available to us. Honesty is the best way to increase discipline and efficiency in public life. In this slide, they are telling us advantage of cooperation. In a family, we cooperate with each other. What the meaning of cooperation is helping each other in completing a work. Similarly, a team sport, that is either a kho-kho or it is a hockey or football. The more the players cooperation with each other, the better is their game. Instead of keeping the feeling of cooperation restricted to sports, we should also bring into a public life as well. Everybody needs cooperation in public life. We too need the help of others. For example, they're telling us FAD, that is the jatras which we have. Rallies and other such gathering can also be arranged successfully if cooperation with one and another. Do you know 2011, they're telling about the cricket match. Sachin Tendulkar, right at the beginning of the match, the bowler appealed to the umpire, the thinking that the ball had not touched the bat. Here they are giving a sport example. However, knowing the ball had touched his bat, Tendulkar returned to the pavilion, though he was declared not out. This is about honesty they are speaking. Now, next one that they are asking us again the question, what's the solution? We meet a boy who has lost his way. Here they're telling us that we have to find our own solution and help others going out of our way. You can help the boy or show him the way. While on a trip, we realize that our friends have forgotten her tiffin. Means we can share the tiffin with another. Some people are stuck in the lift from the building. You can inform the watchman. So these all things are small for us, for helping each other so that we will have a better life in future. Here they have told us to read and discuss about the problem and solution. The first picture, they're telling about the Savita and Samir. They don't want to take them for a picnic because they are playing pranks. Savita is good in singing and Samir is good in jokes. So in the second slide, they are taking advantage of that and they are thinking that Savita and Samir, they have helped them. Yes, that they have helped them and they have been tolerant and gender equality they have explained over here. In tolerance, we all have some faults, that is, we have disadvantages. We are not agreeing with everybody. So we can improve these faults with the help of our family and friends. We may not agree with each other every time. Sometimes there are disagreements even between friends. At such times, we must try to understand the point of view or ideas of other. Instead of insisting that only our point of view is correct. On such occasion, we must listen to each other. In this way, we learn to be tolerant. Respecting the opinions which are different from our own is called tolerance and broad-mindedness. We can continue now. Tolerance has a special significance in our country, importance in our country. People from various religion, creed, culture and follow different customs and live here. So we are coming together as unity in diversity. That is why it is necessary for everyone to be tolerant or broad-minded. Means we should not create an opinion about others very fast. Diversity means difference can be preserved through tolerance. Diversity enriches, means riches our social life, means social activity, interaction with others will be encouraged. It encourages us to think about others with concern, with love. We can solve problems in our environment by being broad-minded. Here we end about the tolerance. Now we'll talk about general equality. General equality means boys and girls which are treated equally. Considering boys and girls to be equal without discrimination is called gender equality. Boys and girls must respect one another. In the company of our friends, we consider all of them to be our equal. We must maintain this sense of equality as citizens when we grow up. By developing this sense of equality, everyone gets to learn and make progress. Food, clothing, shelter, health and education are the common need of men and women. For the purpose of equality, each of these needs must be fulfilled properly. Men and women have equal rights to facilitate such as these. Facilitate means these provisions are provided to us in the constitution also. Similarly, men and women must be equal opportunity for progress. Here they are telling about education and here they are telling, giving us an activity or preparing a slogan. Slogan means a saying about general equality. In this slide, they are telling us about what are the solutions, always remember, and what we have learned. Here they are telling we have to observe in our family. In some home, boys' uniform, textbook, bags are brought first and purchased. But there they are talking about gender equality. Next one, they're telling about how we have to have cooperation with each other. The next one, they're telling about Vandana likes the bat and ball a lot. Okay, here they're telling us that it is not necessary that the girls have only to be home-oriented jobs. Here, they can be bold enough to play out also. Here they are telling about the gender equality and the house chores only to be given to the girls. But here they are telling us that the brother, they are making us think that gender equality is very important. Next one, they are telling about the honesty increase efficiency. That is, we can do our work fast in public life and make it possible to avoid wastage of time, money and labor. Labor means the hard work which we are doing. What we have learned, they have given us some briefing about how should we learn things. Everyone in the family must have a say in decision making. We can take part in decision making. We must be honest in our private and public life. Tolerance and cooperation makes our community life harmonious, peaceful and happy. A tolerant attitude, that is, we are tolerating each other, we are giving our opinions and we are having different opinions, and that is, we are preserving our diversity, differences. Men and women are equal. It is not right to discriminate between them.